What's up, guys? What's up, Cycling Fanatics? Sam woke up every hour this night. Yeah, today, go to Mexico.
Daisy's got another school thing going on today. She's bringing Sam to grandma. I'm gonna get ready for my work day. Pack the bags. We're going to Mexico, where I'm gonna go on a very cool ride. We're gonna ride up to 3,000 meters of elevation. Never been in that altitude or elevation riding my bike. It's gonna be super tough. So I'm gonna pack up my cycling kit again and get ready for the flight. To Mexico is like 11 hours or so, so it's a long flight. We leave at around 4 o'clock this afternoon. All right, I'm ready for work. I ordered an Uber to get to the train station. I always go by train to the airport, which is fast, easy, because it takes me right to where I need to be. And I can look at the flight details on my way to the airport in the train. If you have any questions about flying, you can post them in the comments. I'll see what I can answer about those. So today is going to be another flight to Mexico City. There's an, I think, 8 hour time difference there. We leave around 3 or 4 o'clock in the afternoon. We're going to be arriving there late in the day, drive to the hotel. Probably gonna go to bed straight away. That's the plan of today. Normally when I fly to Mexico, it's way warmer in Mexico than in the Netherlands. But right now, it's exceptionally warm. Today's 30 degrees, tomorrow 35, Tuesday, Wednesday 36. It's gonna be crazy. It's really busy, it's holiday season. So the airport is busy, train is busy. Let's go to Mexico for some cooling. Right, we are at the flight deck in the cockpit. We're gonna prepare everything for the flight. So we're gonna put the entire route in the computer. That's the computer. So we can fly on sort of the autopilot during the whole cruise. So that's gonna take us like 45 minutes to get everything ready, calculate the distances and the takeoff speeds and all that stuff, so we can have a safe operation. I'll see you in Mexico. Arrived in Mexico City in the hotel. What's it, local time? 8:25. Amsterdam time is 3:25, so it's almost 3:30 in the night. So it's another long day today. The flight was nice. We had an unusual route. We had to avoid some weather areas with bad weather, so we went all along the coast of the east coast of USA. It was pretty cool. And then coming into Mexico, there was a lot of rain showers and all that stuff. We had to sort of avoid coming in. I'm not doing the landing here in Mexico, so I was sitting in the back. But it's always everybody's, you know, on focus, because Mexico airport is a high elevation airport, and it always goes fast. The approach speeds are fast because of the elevation, so it's very interesting. It's always interesting to come in to Mexico City. Anyway, the weather forecast for tomorrow is a bit sketchy. It's not as warm as I expected. I thought Mexico summer, it's gonna be 30 degrees or more, so I brought my summer kit. Turns out it's raining and it's gonna be cold, and we're gonna be climbing to 3,000 meters. So I did not bring the warm kit, so I'm not sure what's gonna happen tomorrow. Anyway, I've I'm gonna meet with Joel and the local velo guy tomorrow morning at 5:30. So right now, I'm gonna go to sleep. I'll see you tomorrow.
Good morning. It's about 5:30. I'm gonna catch an Uber to Francesco's house. And that's where I'm gonna meet Francesco and Joel. Joel's gonna join us for this ride of today. And he's gonna be on an e-bike.
Good morning.
Yes, that's me.
Okay, I just arrived here at Frederico's house. This is Frederico.
Hi, how are you?
He's gonna take me on this trip on the ride of today. So I catch the Uber and it's still dark. The city is still asleep.
Yeah.
And I think we're still okay because the roads are all dry, so that's good.
Yeah, roads are dry, which is good, and the city is asleep, which is better because traffic later is not a good news.
Exactly. So it's okay. We're gonna wait for Joel to arrive. He's gonna be arriving right here in a couple minutes, and then we're gonna be setting up the bikes and stuff. Buenas noches.
Buenas noches.
Joel has arrived. That's good.
So it's really apparent that Frederico is a cyclist because I already see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 bikes in one house.
It's like N plus one.
It's all, yeah, you never have enough bikes, I guess.
N plus one house.
Check out the bike that they arranged for me. They actually picked it up yesterday, and it's a specialized. What's it? Tarmac?
Yeah, tarmac.
It's a tarmac with DI2. So that's pretty cool. I'm looking forward to ride this, man. Awesome.
Alright, ready to go. We've got the bike ready. We've got a new kit. Special Mexican style kit that Joel gave me. What's it? What's the kit exactly?
Well, you know, it's the original kit from the BC Busterias, which was where Velogadal began in Mexico 6 years ago.
That's it.
So it's got a reference to Day of the Dead and Sugar Skulls.
That's this.
Yeah.
All right, cool. I am going to shoot, actually, I'm going to shoot a separate video about today's ride. So if you want to see more about this awesome ride to 3,000 meters, you should be checking out that Velo Guide video.
Oh, it's instant coffee.
Works.
We're doing instant coffee, that's it.
Okay, currently at 2800. I'm hauling ass to the top. I'm constantly chased by Joel on the e-bike. It's getting tough now. I'm trying to hold 300 watts, but it's kind of busy with traffic and craziness. Whew. Okay, quick little update. I am now at 3,000 meters. We just climbed up. I keep forgetting the name. What's the name of this again? What's the name of this place?
Desierto Leones.
Desierto Leones. That's where we are right now. Total chaos in the beginning of the climb with traffic and stuff.
It was fun though.
It was kind of crazy. I had this guy on my tail on this e-bike the whole time. Every time we went through traffic, I did a bunch of sketchy moves and I lost him. And then I look around and he's hauling ass with his electric motor again and he's on my tail again. But anyway, totally different world up here. You have to watch this Velo Guide video of Mexico City because you'll see so much more of this ride.
This traffic. It's a loco, eh?
Si. That's some of the recordings of today. Dude, this ride was really cool. It's 3:15 in the afternoon in Mexico right now. I'm gonna go to bed. I'm gonna try and sleep for about 3 hours and then get ready for the flight back home. My head's starting not to work so well. Hey, if you're interested in Velo Guide, and you don't want to wait till the next video, just go click in the link in my description because you'll get a discount towards your next Velo Guide. Go to veloguide.com/jasper and you'll get a discount. Sign up, here you go. It's awesome, just go have a look. It's free to sign up, so don't worry. I'm gonna go to sleep. Now. And then we fly back to Amsterdam. It's 6:30 at night in the afternoon in Amsterdam. No, in Mexico. Totally confused. 6:30 in It's 6:30 in Mexico. It's like, what's that? 2:30 at night in Amsterdam. I just had a nap and then I woke up from the wake up call in the hotel. I still have to pack. I just went in the shower. I have to pack my bag, get ready to go. This is the hardest moment to wake up. Anywhere between like 1 o'clock, 1 and 6 o'clock at night is like when your body clock is at the lowest point. Your body is totally fine with sleeping, but if you want to wake up during this period, it's hard. Anyway, it takes a little while until you're really awake. We're going to be flying back to Amsterdam. Every guy should know how to tie a tie, right? So if you don't know, pay attention. It's really easy. You make a cross, you go around, you go to the middle, put it through, you go around again to the middle, you go around to the front, back to the middle, over the top, in the hole, boom, tight, chop, flip these down, and then you're done. Good luck. All right, it's 6 o'clock, 6:30 actually. Mexico is like the return flight from Mexico is one of the rare flights where I don't go straight to bed when I arrive back home, because we arrive like in the end of the afternoon, and in general the beginning of the flight is actually the hardest because it's in the middle of the night, like I already mentioned. But then you fly into the sun and you're in the light for the rest of the flight. It turns day, your body wakes up. And, you know, I actually start feeling better and better during the flight. When I arrive back home, I'm kind of okay. So tonight I just go to sleep kind of early and then see how I wake up tomorrow. Hey, baby. Hello. You know that feeling you get when you've been sort of working on a task pretty much all day and then you're not really making progression, and at the end of the day you're like, what in the hell have I been doing all day, because I've got nothing. It's sort of how I feel at the moment. I'm like, It's 6:30 Thursday, the weather's great, I've been inside all day, I slept fairly okay, woke up at 9 o'clock in the morning because of the gardener of the back neighbor was cutting the hedges with his freaking combustion engine hedge clipper. So I woke up like, and he did that pretty much all day. So that was a major part of my current frustration status. Dude, so annoying. I had my mom over all day to babysit because I really wanted to get the national championship video done. I want to get the video up this weekend. It's been a long time I've posted a race video, so I really want to get this video up. So I'm editing the video. I'm not even editing, I'm just scanning the footage. And it's a 4-hour race. So that's 4 hours of footage to scan. It takes me all day. And I've got a certain idea about how this race went down. And I'm looking at the footage and I'm like, dude, it was total chaos. Whatever I thought I was doing, or whatever I thought had happened, It was very, very different. I don't even know how to make a story out of this race. It was chaos. Maybe that's the story. Like I said, I'm totally frustrated because I sort of got nothing done. I made a few calls, did some emails, but after I get home from a trip, it always takes a little time to catch up, you know? And that's one of the things I sort of look against when I get home, catching up with all this crap before I can actually start doing something. I hardly made any progression with the V of the national championship. Tomorrow me and Daisy are celebrating our birthday, so it's gonna be another busy day. I'm not sure when I'm gonna get this done. So right now I'm like, dude, I have to get on the bike, go out for a little spin. And took my homie, where is he? Sam. Hey. So Sam's behind me. We're doing maybe like an hour and a half maybe, tops. Just to get outside. I mean, look at the weather. Sun's out, freaking guns out. Another thing that's sort of feeding my frustration is the fact that I realize that I'm missing something very essential. If I want to step up my results, if I want to perform better in racing, there's something that I'm missing and it's very hard to get. And that's exposure, experience. The fact that I only raced 5 races before the Nationals, that's not enough. It's not enough to know the competition. It's not enough to get your tactical skills. Yeah, that's what's sort of bothering me, because there's no way I can get more exposure. With my current lifestyle, it's very difficult to race more races. And it's not like the first time that somebody comes up to me after the race and is like, hey man, you look very strong today, but you're racing super stupid. You're chasing the wrong guys. You're not doing the right moves. You're closing gaps that you shouldn't, or you're letting gaps open that you shouldn't. That's a bit frustrating, and I know that. And I can see it when I watch my races. I mean, I spend hours watching my races because I'm editing those. And I can see I'm not doing the right moves, but to be in the race and oversee that and do what you should do, or to do the smart thing, that's very difficult. And I'm not sure if I can get that. I don't think I'm able to race more races than I'm doing now with my job, with YouTube, with the family, with the baby. And so I'm never gonna get enough exposure to be able to step up my results. So maybe road racing is not, maybe it's not my thing. Another ride in the books. Tomorrow we're celebrating our birthday, so there's gonna be a party. Guys, I'm gonna think about racing. Maybe I'm just gonna do some criteriums. I don't know. Let me know what you think down below. Gonna see you next time. See ya!